students, in this lecture, we'll see what is momentum. So for that, let us consider one example. See, here we have two vehicles, a cycle and a truck. Both of them are moving towards the boy in yellow t-shirt. We know that the mass of cycle is less than that of truck, but both of them are moving with same velocity towards the boy. Now, what do you think? If the boy wants to stop these vehicles, for him to stop the cycle will be easier or to stop the truck will be easier? Obviously, for the boy to stop the cycle will be easier than to stop the truck. Why? Both of them were moving with same velocity. But the reason is the mass of cycle is lesser than that of truck. Okay? So what we can understand from this example, that the force applied by the boy is directly proportional to the mass of the vehicle. If the mass of the vehicle is less, then the boy has to apply less force on that vehicle to stop it. Okay? So although the velocity of both the vehicles is same, here you can see I have written V and V for both the balls. Means velocity of both the balls are same, both the vehicles are same. But masses are different, M1 was greater than M2. So force required to stop the body having higher mass is more. So I can say that force is directly proportional to mass. Now we'll take another example, and in that example, suppose we have two bodies of same masses. Now both these bodies are moving with different velocities. V1 velocity is greater than V2. Now suppose if you want to stop these bodies, then where you will require a larger force? Masses to dono body ke same hi the, hai na? To kisko rokne mein aapko zyada taakat lagani padegi? Yes, obviously, you will have to apply more force to stop the body moving with higher velocity. Jo zyada speed se aapke taraf aa raha hoga, usko rokne mein aapko zyada force lagana padta hai. Therefore, we can say that the force required to stop the ball with V1 is more, and so I can conclude that the force is directly proportional to velocity. Agar koi bhi cheez aapke taraf move kar rahi hai, dheere dheere move kar rahi hai, to aap usko easily rok sakte ho. अगर बहुत स्पीड से आपकी तरफ आ रही है तो उसको रोकने के लिए आपको ज़्यादा फोर्स लगाना पड़ता है. तो फ्रॉम बोथ दीज एग्जाम्पल्स व्हाट वी कैन से इज दैट फोर्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू मास एज वेल एज फोर्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वेलोसिटी. सो वन न्यू फिजिकल क्वांटिटी वॉज फ्रेम्ड बाई कंबाइनिंग मास एंड वेलोसिटी, एंड दैट फिजिकल क्वांटिटी इज नोन एज मोमेंटम. So momentum is actually product of mass and velocity, and its symbol is small p. Now we'll see the MKS unit, that is the SI unit of momentum. We know its formula, it is mass into velocity. So what is the SI unit of mass? It is kg. What is the SI unit of velocity? It is meter per second. So the SI unit or the MKS unit of momentum is kg meter per second. And now the CGS unit, it will be gram centimeter per second. So this is what is momentum, the product of mass and velocity.